Hello and welcome to this review of Animaytor software. So this software is for PC and Mac, and it just allows you to create very simple, quite nice looking animated videos. You can see I've already built one here. I'm going to talk through how to do it, and I'm firstly going to talk about the price. So at the moment you can get Animaytor as professional or business, and they're around $65. I got mine with a $40 off voucher, so I think I paid $25 and I went for the business. There's quite a big difference between the business and the professional, and it's only a few dollars more, so I went for the business. You can also upgrade and get this maximizer, and that I think is another $47. And at this point it's starting to get expensive, and I don't know if it represents such good value. Certainly I can see a lot in the Maximizer commercial that looks really good, like full HD, some panning and zooming, really good slide transitions. But I don't have that. I just have the commercial package, and that's what I'm going to review today. So first of all, I'm going to go to new, and I'm going to create a new project, and I'm going to call my project demo 2. I'm going to have the slide size as full HD. However, it doesn't render in full HD on this package. It actually renders at 720. So we can use these built-in themes. I quite like this one, but we've got mattes, we've got pastels, shiny, sun rays, and watercolors, or we can do a custom one. But we can't do a custom one because clicking on that doesn't do anything. And I find that in this software, you've got to upgrade to get all the features. It looks like you've got a feature here, but you haven't because clicking on it doesn't do anything. I'm going to go with bright. Bright is by far the best for me. So we start off with some text, and if we double click on it, we can go into a text editor. So I'm just going to make something up in order to show you how this works. Have you been after video training? Now it can appear, if I just left it like that, it would just be on the slide. I quite like it appearing. So this essentially gives transitions into the video, and they're quite good and they look quite professional. So I'm going to have appear left to right. This I think is milliseconds, and I'm going to go for 1,000. And we can have it word by word, line by line, letter by letter, etc. Let's go for word by word. We can also have it disappear. Just going to have it rotate out. What I quite like is you can do random as well. We came in left to right, so we're going to go left to right again, and we're going to click OK. So now down here we've got our slides, and we can vary the length of the slides, and we can vary this text. So I can drag it out, and I can drag basically the disappearing out. So I'm going to have more text. So let's just have a look at that. So watch what happens. Have you been after training? So it just zooms in from the side. I can adjust the position of this, and I can adjust that. So there's no alignment tool, so I think I'm roughly in the center here. So let's watch this again. When we want to add another slide, we just click on this plus, and it gives a slide in a different color. Now, if we want to, we can go and change that color. The interface isn't particularly helpful. It looks like you've got to load it yourself here, but if you click it, actually there's quite a lot that already come with the software. I'm just going to stick with the standard colors. If I want to add text, I can, and I'm going to add some text. Then look no further than Big G Photo. And again, we're going to do a slightly different appearance. We're going to go for top to bottom, flying in. I'm going to have it at 1500 milliseconds, and I'm going to do it word by word, disappear, just going to fly out, and that's that. I don't really like how that's aligned, so I'm just going to change that. Like so, quite happy with that. And again, I'm going to play it just to see what we've got. I quite like that. It's worked this out automatically down here. I'm quite happy with that. But I'm going to add some images. So again, it's not very intuitive. We have to go to add. It comes with lots and lots of assets and says from the clouds. I haven't really looked at that. Just going to look at my local, and we've got characters. and I'm going to use this businessman here. So I'm going to click OK. And again, we can do how they appear, and I'm just going to click OK. So they've appeared down here. They appear up here for some reason, which isn't particularly helpful. So I'm going to move them down here, and I'm going to scale them up. Now, probably I want to add in something like something to a YouTube or a laptop. So let's have a look. Now, we can't search these. We just have to scroll through. Not great, but there we are. Here's a computer. Oh, that seems to have disappeared. Here we are. So I'm going to add that in. And I quite like that. That looks pretty good. This looks like a GIF. So I'm going to put that on loop. So I can't select it here, so I'm going to select it here. This is a bit annoying. And again, I want to scale it down. So I've got to rearrange everything. But yeah, I'm quite happy with that. So let's just have a look at this. So I want the text to be there for longer. There we are. So I think you can get quite professional results with this. Now, I don't actually want to add a transition in, but I'm going to show the transition. So again, these ones look really good, but we can't use them because I don't have the right package. I have to go to GIF animation, and again, I have to pick one. So there's loads and loads of GIF animations. This seems a bit slow in catching up. And that is a little bit annoying. You scroll down and then it suddenly jumps. I'm going to click on that one. I'm going to click OK. And I'm just going to click OK here, and it applies it. So now as we drag through, as we scrub through, that should have a transition between the slides. Let's have a look at that. I don't think the transition is needed. I think just going to a different color slide and then having things appear is good enough. Possibly you might think the transition takes away from it, so we can go to edit and transitions. And all we have to do is click on none, click OK, and it disappears. We can add more than one bit of text if we want. So I'm going to add more text. First, I need to click on add to add a new text box, and I'm going to put big G photo. The color I want is black because I'm going to put it inside the computer. And I'm going to take it down to 50. And that is great. So I want that to appear after the laptop. So again, let's just have a quick preview of that. So what I might want to do is I might just want to add another slide. If I'm finishing there, I don't think it's particularly good to sort of have things pop away. So I'm just going to add another slide. And what I'm going to do is I just want to change the color, really. So background. Again, got to scroll through. I want the same color as before. Not being able to search is a bit of a difficulty. So let's add that in. Okay. So now this is what's going to happen. They'll disappear and I'm left with a blank slide. So I think that looks much more polished. Unfortunately, we can't do any transitions where it fades to black. Those transitions aren't available, and we certainly can't do any transitions on the last slide, which is unfortunate. So I've added images, I've added people, and I've added an animation, but there's other things. There's graphics, there's effects, and overlays are quite good as well, shapes, and you can also upload your own. So there's plenty of things to make your video look polished, and you know what? They're not that difficult to add in. Yes, you could easily do this with another piece of software. With this software, what I like about it is that you get a lot of the assets with it, and it's simple and it's very quick. So I'm going to go to sound now, and it comes up with these notifications. We can only add in these notifications like alarms and birds and other things, camera shutter. We can also import audio if we want to. I'm not going to. Now, if we want to have background music, we click here to enable the background track. And again, we have to go to search for what we've got, and it comes up with what we've got already included. I think Sunny sounds quite good. I double click and it imports it from the catalog. We can click here to play. Well, that sounds fantastic. We can loop the playback, we can go for volume. Most likely the music is going to be longer than the video you're putting together anyway, so there's no need to loop it. So I'm going to click OK. And if we scroll down to the bottom, we've got our track. And this goes all the way up to 42 seconds. So this might be one you might want to loop for longer videos. My video is not going to be longer than 42 seconds, so I'm not going to loop it. So what will happen is the sound will stop here. There isn't a way to fade the sound down, unfortunately. And the sound doesn't integrate particularly well. And we'll talk about that a bit later. So now if I play it from the start, we've got sound included. Great. So that's really good, and like I say, the sound will stop at the end. So sound stops at the end. So now we could go and produce the video, but before we do that, I just want to talk about some other things we can do. We can add in a watermark, text or image. So I might want to watermark this as big G photo. I can put it on the right, in the center, or on the left. I can change the opacity here. There we are. Now once that's in, I can't move that. So if I go to watermark again, I'm going to put it on the right hand side. It stays where it is. There are some buggy things in the software, and that's one of them. I can't seem to find where the watermark is. So I'd have to go to none, close it, and then I'd have to go back into watermark. So none, okay, that removes it. I'd have to go watermark, text, big G photo on the right. It's still in the same place. So buggy, yes. I'm not sure how to solve that, but you can add in a watermark if you want to. I have no idea what this sync is. I looked at it, I think it's backing up to a cloud server, but I'm not sure. You can record a voiceover. The voiceover is buggy. I will say that it is a buggy voiceover. And you can do a script where you type text in and it does text-to-speech. I do like text-to-speech. It is useful. If you don't want to say it, you can get someone else to do it. But it will ruin what we've got here. So before I go into the voiceover and the script, I'm going to export this. We're going to look at it, and then I'm going to come back and I'm going to talk about scripting and voiceover. So I go to produce. It gives me a destination file already. I'm quite happy with that. I'm just going to call this output 2. And you'll notice I can't click full HD. I set my quality to high and I'm going to start. So it isn't the quickest of things. I've got quite a powerful PC considering it's only 14 seconds. It seems to take more than real time to do the rendering. So once it's rendered, I'll put it up on the screen and we can have a look at what we've got. So it's not the best quality, it's 720. It will be fine for social media, which is what I would use it for. So now I'm going to click back here and I'm going to go to voiceover. We need to enable the voiceover track. We want to record voice. I need to pick what I'm going to use. I'm going to use my microphone. And if I click record, then it's just a bit weird. Watch this. Have you been after video training? So it just stops there. Can you see that? It just stops there. I need to click on next slide. Then look no further than the big G photo. Big G photo. I need to click on next slide. So I'm going to click stop. And I'm going to click OK. and then our track gets added in down here. So because I didn't click next slide quick enough, it's made this slide longer, which is not really what I want. And also, I can't go and edit this. So I can double click on it. I can take off the voiceover if I want. I'm not going to do that yet. But I can't chop bits out. I can't edit it. You get one go with the voiceover and you've got to do it right. This scissor is for cutting background music. It's not for cutting out the voiceover or editing the voiceover. So the voiceover, I don't think is very good. You can't edit it. Voiceovers are tricky, you're never going to get them right, and they seem to mess things up. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just remove it. That's gone. I'm going to try and put things back to the way they were. And that's back to the way it was. So I'm going to do the script now. I can load a script in if I want to. Hi, how are you today? Do you like Big G Photo Channel? Now I can convert it to a different language. I don't want to do that. I can do text to speech. I'm going to go for English British because I'm British. I'm going to go for Brian because he's a male. So I'm going to save that voice file, and it saves as a WAV file. So I'm just going to save it here. I'm going to call it demo 2 and save the WAV file. I'm going to click OK. And you can see it's just completely thrown out my previous project, what I was doing. It's overwritten it, and it puts the text here and it will speak it as well. So here we go. So that was that. So I would recommend if you're doing the script, you do the script first and then you go and add your slides in and add in your characters and everything else that you're going to do, because if you do it afterwards, what will happen is the scripting will just overwrite everything, which I think is a shame. Overall, I think this is a good piece of software. Certainly, it's worth $25. Is it worth $67? Meh, up to you. Would it be really good with the upgrades? Yes, it would. But now we're sort of talking at over $100, and I don't know if the value on that is so good. Certainly, if you can get it for a discounted price, then I would say go for it. If you cannot, I don't know. It's better than most, but as you can see, it has a few bugs, maybe has a bit of limited application, but certainly if you're doing social media videos and you're doing other types of videos of this ilk, or you just want text to slide in and you want a few effects and you want to do short videos, then this is great. Thank you. Goodbye.